fan of the Hauraki Big Show podcast? Make sure you check out more from Jace, Mike and Keezy on their Instagram at Hauraki Big Show, or tune into them 4 to 7 every weekday on Radio Hauraki. Thanks, mate.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Pugs is here.
Yeah, he is. Hey, Pugs-san, what's going on? What? Is that a new hairdo, or is it just that you're not wearing a cap?
It's both, Jace.
Oh, right.
Sick hairdo.
Thank you so much.
I was Chris. I have been pondering whether or not I should do the mini moulet, because you already had one back in the day, right?
I did have one back in the day. I'm trying to get it back.
Yeah.
What's the mini moulet?
Well, like, not a full-blown huge mullet, just a nice...
Because my hair's not quite long enough for the full filthy lid. So I've just got the shape of it and letting it grow into it.
Sure. No, it looks great, Pugs.
Can I just say, I've got a little bit of imposter's guilt about being in the seat again. Feel bad for Mogi.
Yeah, I
just miss him being in the seat, you know?
Sure.
Well, for the audience, he was here.
Yes.
I walked in, everyone was here, and then he goes...
Oh, Keezy's here, I'm off.
He said, hey, Keezy, I'm going home. And I was like, oh, yeah, you're not coming to the batch? Nah. Oh, you're going to come and do the show? Oh, nah, not even going to do that.
Yeah.
So, Todd That's Boss is like, nah, he just sounds like shit. He's clearly
Well, I thought he sounded fine, actually.
Oh.
Well, like, he sounded like he's tired. He's gassed.
Who isn't?
Are you tired?
I'm always tired, man.
From what?
Mind you, guess what I just had, fellas?
Uh-oh. Red Bull?
Yeah. Hence why you're telling us to hurry up.
Especially.
It's good shit, man. It's good shit. Well, my wife bought a 4-pack yesterday.
My wife!
And
sorry, I just had a Red Bull.
Jesus.
And I was coming to drive into work today, and I was like, oh, I feel a bit
woozy.
Not woozy, just quite tired.
Lethargic.
Because I went and did a bit of a shop this morning to get some Kai for us fellas.
Really?
Yeah,
oh,
totally.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Some beautiful... I tell you what, the cheese board...
I don't want to know. Give it a surprise.
The cheese board's going to be a doozy.
She'll
be great, the mate.
The charcuterie board.
It's Red Bull.
And so I was like, oh, fuck. And then had a Red Bull and feel fine now.
Yeah, cool. I can't wait, I don't
feel any different. I mean, I feel sort of, you know what I mean.
You're talking faster.
Sure.
Well,
you know what was really sad?
Hang on. In an hour's time, you're going to be like, oh, I shouldn't have had that Red Bull.
No, in an hour's time, I'll smash another one.
Yeah, probably.
So by the time we get to the batch, I'll be fucking fizzing.
It'll be Chris and I playing Scrabble.
Fizzing. You know what was really sad, though? It's weird.
Yeah, I can definitely tell he's had a Red Bull, right? His movements are way faster. 100.
And also he's barely stringing the sentence together right now.
Seriously, am I? No. My dog, Rue.
Who? Rue.
She knows when we're going to the bat. She just knows. And like my wife's not coming, obviously, but she knew I was.
But maybe you do give off batch energy.
It'll be because you're so excited and happy about going.
Well,
and that just translates.
I did have a little tutu in my fishing bag. And also, if you pack a bag, she goes, yeah, let's do it. Yeah. And then she whines.
Wait, is Rue coming with us?
Yeah, she's going in your car.
How good?
No, she's not. But she whines and just, and you know, you go up to check the mail or whatever, and she just runs up to the fence and is like, what are you doing? Where are you going? I feel really bad because that's her favorite place in the world too. She loves it at the batch.
Man, I wanted to meet Rue.
Can I? Genuine question, me not having a pillow, is that an issue?
No, there's pillows there, Keezy.
Okay, and a towel?
Oh, did you not bring a towel either?
No, so I was on the motorway, and you know how there was that crash on the way in?
Yes.
And I was stuck in all that traffic, it was a pain in the ass. Mm. I texted my wife, I was like, forgot my hoodie, forgot a towel, and forgot my pillow.
How did you manage to do that? I should have had a Red Bull.
To be fair, Keezy had other things to think about. He's organised the Yui Boom for us. He's also picked up the poker set and packed the board games too. So I don't blame you for getting some stuff.
I had to go buy a new sleeping bag as well. But I literally have all that stuff. It's on a pile on my couch. I just grabbed everything that I could carry. I'll do two loads to the car and then just did the first load and that was it.
Wow.
So there's still a fat load still on my couch.
Nothing wrong with a second load, brother.
To ease your mind, Keezy, of course there's pillows.
Is there a spare hoodie?
Not your size. Oh, actually,
you can wear my sweatshirt if you want.
Actually, Pete's pretty big.
Oh, thanks, Jace. I'm pretty big.
Well, you know, he's quite tall.
Yeah.
There's probably something you can chuck on. And anyway, I saw that you had your puffer there.
I've got my puffer.
You'll be sweet as.
Yeah. I couldn't.
And we have towels, so yes, that's fine.
My outdoorsy shirt. Remember the one I was going to chuck in for fishing?
Oh, yeah, in case you got fish guts on yourself.
Yeah, that's I washed it. and it's still drying, so I couldn't wear that either.
Oh, heck.
Oh no.
Did you bring a fishing hat, Pugs?
I did, yeah. It's in my bag.
Good. Great.
We
brought both, actually, the fishing beanie also.
So here's
in
the
case it's chilly.
Tugboat beanie.
It is chilly. How good is how's the weather today, by the way?
It's amazing. Lovely.
If it's like this tomorrow, it's going to be fucking primo.
Shit, yeah, you guys are going to have so much fun.
High tide, three. Well, where are you going to be? Are you not coming either?
No, because Mogi's not going, so I'm not.
Oh, that is even
honestly.
It's getting so. Jace's perfect scenario is that you also pull out and that he's just there at
the back.
Yeah,
fair enough. Like, there's nothing better than cancelled plans, am I right?
Fellas, you can't do that to me, though, because I've spent, you know, money getting food in there.
No, Jace, I'm bloody coming, mate. Even if you weren't going.
The Hauraki Big Show, weekdays from 4 on Radio Hauraki. The Hauraki Big Show podcast.
But seriously, if it's like this, it is going to blow your mind. But then I was thinking about it, actually, because it's high tide 3 o'clock, which is perfect. You know, I don't want to blow it up too much here, because you guys might get there and go, fucking shithole.
I'm picturing.
You won't.
I don't think I will. I think in any scenario, I'm literally just grateful to be getting away and going to stay somewhere. You know, you don't know many people that have a batch on standby.
Well, seriously, man. Yeah. I genuinely feel I'm very grateful that I have this place to go to. Genuinely.
Yeah.
And I've been going to it for like 20 years. So, you know, she's got a place. And, you know, and all my little girls grew up there. And, you know, you'll see some photos on the of a younger buffer.
Yeah. You know what we should do is take the pants man. He can take photos of all the embarrassing ones and put them straight online.
Yeah.
Without even asking. Question. Oh, no, I've forgotten.
That's was you awesome. Really are.
Yeah.
It was important too.
Did what you ever read as well?
It was about the batch.
Oh.
Shit. Nah, flag it. Don't worry.
Okay,
I had spicy noodles for lunch.
Uh-oh. What's... You people know how the stuff affects you. You know how the Red Bull affects you. You know how the spicy noodles affects
Pugs.
You. And yet, before the show,
don't you dare
smash it.
I am genuinely amazed, Keezy, that you forgot stuff. Because you're generally very organised.
You are a very organised person.
I had the spicy noodles, right? Because I was seriously the best noodles you can ever get, and you're going to laugh at this. Food court at Sylvia Park.
And then what?
You ended up having I feel about Sylvia. No, you go, Jace.
You had a massive midday steamer and you just lost your mind.
Jace,
is that what you're saying?
I always have morning steamers, right? Stop being silly.
I feel about Sylvia Park how he feels about Pam. Not going to fucking Sylvia Park.
You have never been to this place. It is amazing. It's upstairs in the little like designer area.
I hate malls.
Best noodles ever. Hang on, wait.
Yes.
So I bought the noodles, ate them, got a sleeping bag, got a poker set. Traffic all the way on the southern back to my place. It was 40 minutes during the day. It's like, what the hell? Get home, lie on my bed. The sun's just streaming in. And then I'm just like there for ages. I can't be fucked. And then my missus is like, hey, it's 2:30. You need to be at work at 3 and you haven't even packed your bags yet. And I was like,
why did you go home and lie down on your bed?
From Sylvia Park.
What's that about?
All the way back out west.
I was in my truck. I wanted to take my truck out for a run.
Okay.
Because I like to do that on a nice day. And then I was like, oh, I'll take the truck home because I'm not going to take that to the batch. And I didn't realize traffic was going to be that bad. I didn't realize it was going to take that long.
But you still haven't answered my question, Keezy. Why did you go home and go to bed?
No, I lay on my bed because the sun was streaming. Because it was my wife was sitting on the bed doing her work and the sun was streaming in. And I just lay next to her there and I was just like, oh, this is nice, isn't it? And then sort of like dozed for a bit.
Oh, okay. Oh, no, I got it.
No, don't. Oh, no, I got it. Me.
Yeah, no. No, I understand.
And I was full of spicy pork lamb noodles, and I just lay there like, ugh. And then she's like, you're going to get your bags packed? I was like, I'll do it quick. I'm pretty good at packing. And then I forgot a pile.
I was so paranoid about leaving the house this morning with all my stuff. It was literally like a little kid going.
Well,
I had my backpack on. I had my sleeping bag in one hand, my pillow in the other.
I was I'm a shocker for that sort of shit. And, you know, and the batch keys every fucking time. My wife and I are like, I said to my wife, where are the batch keys? And she said, oh, yeah, that's a good question.
Isn't there a spare key that you just leave somewhere?
There is a spare key.
Yeah.
but I'm not going to say where the spare key is.
Yeah, okay. Of course.
But we don't have the spare key.
Right.
But, yeah, there was half an hour of frantic. And then she was like, oh, no, we went in your car, so it's probably in your glove box. And I went, oh, Jesus, yes, you're right. So I went into my glove box and it wasn't there. And at this point I was going, oh, for fuck's sake, this is a problem. And then we eventually found them in a little silver thingy. But thank the funny God. Thing is that we do that every time we go to the batch.
You should. No, I'm not going to say anything.
We should hang them in one spot. Yes. I know. Yeah. But
my wife is the same.
We never do.
We have a key bowl and she can never find her keys. Yeah. Put them in the bowl. All right? Sure. We have a key bowl, just us two.
Ah.
Yeah.
All right, now, who's out?
Oh, we're still doing the podcast, you know that, eh?
Are we?
You're about to do some admin there. Yeah.
Hey, fellas, Haraki Big Show tagged me in a reel. Let's have a look.
It's of Mogi on his TV show starring.
Never any shit on me on our
thing. Yeah. Don't worry, I've got a video. I've actually made a video of the outro clip prank yesterday. Because that was quite funny.
Yeah, the beeping.
I had fun with that.
Yeah, it was good. It was really good.
It was a good time. A little bit self-serving.
Hey. Listen to Hodaki 4-7 every weekday, all right? That's when the big show's on.
Hey, fellas.
What?
Huh?
Life in the Bay liked my story.
Who the? Oh,
by the way, you know how you shared your pie flavour?
Oh, I thought
we put it on in
Hang on. You shared my pie flavour.
Yeah, well, that's what.
So you have to swipe across to your one and then hit share. Because now he's just shared my mozzarella pie, which I'm happy about.
Speaking of pie flavours, I had a chicken katsu curry today from over the road there.
Good.
It's unreal, man.
Yeah, good shit,
like,
mate.
Could use a little more spice, but delicioso. That's my story.
Thanks, mate.
Anyway,
sounds
really
delicious
good.
And then, it sounds really good, Pugs. Keep talking, baby.